Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making strawberry cream cake. It's a cake I know you'll love. And it's a good time of the year to have it because strawberries are still inexpensive, at least where I live. So it starts with a cake that I picked up from the deli. I don't know if you can see this pan I took it out of. It's an angel food cake. Actually, it would be better if you made the angel food cake, but I felt like for my purposes, if I spent my time making the angel food cake, I wouldn't have any time to show you the real strawberry cream part of the cake. So if you want to make your own angel food cake, it will be a better cake, bigger, and look nicer. But this looks plenty good. You'll see it's a beautiful cake. So start out with an angel food cake. The first thing you do with your angel food cake is to slice a layer off the top. If it's a large cake, make it 1 inch. I was shooting more for 3/4 inch, and it was a little slanted, and I really tried to level up the cake a little bit. Now I'm going to use one of my own tips here. If you look through my quick tips, occasionally I'll have one that works. And one that I used here was to freeze the angel food cake before I started cutting on it. That way it slices so much easier. I just sliced across there with it frozen. It came right off. I saved the orientation on this plate because it'll be going back onto the top after we do a lot of stuff in here. What I did in here was to take a sharp knife. This is really a steak knife. I was thinking it's the closest to a bread knife. And I could just come around and make a channel. So I had to go around the outer edge. You can see I probably went 1/2 to 3/4 inch. If this had been a large cake, it would have been 1 inch. And then on the inside, I also cut around here about the same amount, leaving 1/2 inch or so. Again, with a large angel food cake, I would have gone in 1 inch both ways. You can see that I have removed the cake pieces that were in here. I used the knife and cut them into like squares and then pulled them out or tugged them out with the knife, and here they are. So you'll see that the composition is pretty much square where I started, and then it got a little harder, so I was just tugging with my fingers to get these out. But it doesn't really matter. They're going to be mixed up in something later on. So the preparation of your angel food cake at the beginning is quite important because we're going to mix up some luscious stuff that goes right in here, and it's called strawberry cream. Okay, let's go to the making of the strawberry cream. I start with 1 8-ounce package of cream cheese, and I chose fat-free variety. You can use regular. It doesn't really matter. I've already beat it with a mixer, so it's nice and fluffy. I had it at room temperature to do that, and that's very important. I'm going to add to that 1 can of the Eagle brand sweetened condensed milk. And this is fat-free. I try to do that every time I get a chance. You know, angel food cake is something that is even allowed on diabetic diets, so it doesn't have a lot of sugar, has no fat. This is your 14-ounce can, and I'm just going to pour that in here. Beat this at this point. That's not necessary. You can just go ahead and add the next ingredient, which is lemon juice, and I'm using this reconstituted lemon juice from a jar because it's just so much easier than squeezing enough lemons to get 1/3 of a cup. Add in 1/3 of a cup of lemon juice, and then add almond flavoring, almond extract, or this is just imitation almond flavor, 1 teaspoon. There we go. Now I want to stir that together, and actually I think that what I want to do is, when I get it stirred a little bit, is beat it with the mixer. This mixture will be very homogeneous if you mix it with a mixer. If you just stir it, it's not going to be quite as smooth as would be desirable. To this mixture, we're going to add strawberries. And this is 2 cups of strawberry slices. You'll see that I sliced them pretty thin. My strawberries were pretty large. I would rather them have been smaller, but I could have sliced them in half again. It really doesn't matter. It's just that You know where we're going with this. We're going to fill that channel, and it would be easier if we had smaller berries. But you need 2 cups, and if you want to work with those and make those chopped up more finely, then that's up to you. And then also, all of that cake that we pulled out and saved, put that in. So this makes quite a large mixture here. And what we're going to do is just take this spoon and stir it around. So this is what our mixture looks like when it's all together. And let's bring the cake over a little bit where I can reach it. And what I'm going to do is spoon this in. And if, oops, I think I spilled some on the plate. I may have to do a cleanup after this. If this big spoon is too large for that channel, then I'll just go down to a smaller spoon. So I have filled up the channel with our strawberry cream, and it's gonna make this taste just wonderful. But it's gonna be hidden in there because I'm gonna put the top back on. And I tried to keep the top in the same orientation as when I took it off. I knew it was thinner on the left-hand side than it was on the right-hand side because the cake was not level. But I just replace it just like it had never been moved. And I do want to point out to you that when you put an angel food cake on your cake stand or on a cake plate, you get it out of your package and the large part goes on the bottom and then it slopes up to the smaller. So the next step here is this gets wrapped with a plastic wrap and I put it in the refrigerator for at least 8 hours. So I don't get to eat it today, and that's a big disappointment. However, and we will do some more with this tomorrow. I will finish it up for you tomorrow. However, we do have all of this left. I probably wouldn't have had that left if I had had a normal sized angel food cake to work with. But having that amount left, I can serve that into a nice bowl. And I could decorate that up some if I wanted to, but actually this is just going to be a snack for me and my husband tonight when we're watching TV. And when I get a serving out, it'll be pretty much something like, after it is chilled a bit, it won't be this runny, but I'll be able to dig in and place it in a serving bowl. And we'll have our strawberries and cream that has little bits of cake in it, but it's not our full-blown cake that we're going to see tomorrow. My strawberry cream filled cake has been in the refrigerator overnight, covered with plastic, and it should be nice and set up inside that channel that we filled. So we're going to give it an icing. And that icing is just going to be a simple whipped topping. You're not going to really have to prepare anything, but this is perfect for something like angel food cake, particularly angel food cake that you have added some kind of fruit or pudding or some statement of your own. And it's just a matter of taking a spreader like this, or you could use just a knife if you like, and go over all of it. And I'll just give you an idea of the start. And you can see I just plan to go around all the outside, all the inside here, and the top. I have iced my cake with the whipped topping, and I just wanted to point out this is an 8-ounce container, and I had that much left, so it's just about a half of the container that I used. I was able to level it out, and I would like to point out that I used regular for this purpose, for this demonstration. Regular holds its shape better. So if you're icing, I would suggest regular. If it were just for me and my family to eat, I would use low fat, and that would be the third low fat item that I could have, or fat free item that I could have put in here. You notice the decoration I have on the top. I had some strawberries left over from the original strawberries that I bought for this recipe. And I just took slices like this and decided to make sort of a free form design. Do whatever you like with those. But this is our strawberry cream filled cake. So this is what your strawberry cream cake looks like when the filling is set up. And you can see the top and back and of course the bottom. And here's the cake itself, if you can see inside that a little bit. It's really a pretty cake and it tastes great.